Hey you guys, what's going on? It's Teenage Night and I am here for week 12 of Riker Sterling's freshman season. We come into week 12 at 8-1 and number 3 in the country. I believe our last win was over Baylor. I'm not going to lie, it's been like 2 or 3 weeks since I played this game. I bulk recorded a bunch right before Christmas break and now I'm just now getting back to recording them. But yes, our last game we did beat Baylor 50 to 43, and then we have Iowa State at Kansas State and then at Oklahoma State. So we have 3 games left to try to get into that number 2 spot. Let's go ahead and check BCS rankings. I know you guys probably just saw this stuff a few days ago, but like I said, it's been a few weeks since I have. So with BCS rankings, we are still number 4. Stanford is number 3. How did they jump? Oh, they beat Oregon. Okay. And then you got Notre Dame at 2, Auburn at 1. So the only undefeated team left is Auburn. And I don't know if they're going to lose the rest of this year. Going down the rest of this, I don't see any other undefeated teams. So yeah, it looks like the only relevant team that is still undefeated is Auburn. So we're going to need Notre Dame or Stanford to lose, and we have to win out. And Arizona did lose to UCLA 17-28. And we still didn't move because Stanford jumped us and Notre Dame moved up and everything else. But let's go ahead and check Heisman Watch before we jump into this week's game. And we are still number 1 on the Heisman watch list. Okay. Last game, 13 of 17, 363 yards, 16 carries, 38 yards, and 4 total touchdowns. Okay. Obviously, after our bowl game, because we will most likely... Yeah, we're definitely going to a bowl game with 8 wins, even if we lose out from here. But after our bowl game, we will go in and look at the season stats. But for right now, let's go ahead and jump into this game against Iowa State. Okay, so before we get into this game, I'm going to try something new, probably for the rest of this season, and then get your feedback. So the first games of this season, I cut out play selection and stuff like that, and obviously the videos were coming out like 4 and 5 days in between. What I'm going to try these next few games is I'm going to show everything from the start of the game all the way to the end, and then cut to next week. So I only have to do like 2 cuts in editing. So I might be able to get one out like every day or every other day. That would be my goal, and see how fast we can get through this series and maybe do something else with NCAA 14. Maybe they'll come with a new one soon, but let's go ahead and skip to when we're on the field. And all right, so we do have the ball first. So let's see what we can do today. So you will see play selection. You will see everything that I do. Hopefully I can talk through most of this game. And then at the end, we will jump to next week, and I don't see anyone open. Got a scramble. And throw on the run to a wide-open guy. Sterling Shepard, first down. Okay. 25-yard gain to start off today. I kind of got the idea to do commentating like this from the NFL Tour, like, mini-series that I did for the playoffs. And it was a lot of fun to just commentate throughout the whole thing. So I think I'm going to try that. We're going to see how that goes over the next few games. And if you guys enjoy it, let me know. Realize that if you guys want me to go back to the other one, then they're going to be coming out less frequently. But if I can commentate them like this... It's very, very little editing. So I can, you know, record, edit in like maybe 2 minutes, render, and then upload it for the next day or something. So that's the way it would pretty much go from here on out. But let's go ahead and get back into this game. First and 10, Samaje Perine in the backfield. That's where we're going with it. We're going to need them to block. Okay, he got his guy. And all right, 7-yard gain on the play. Also, I noticed while I was editing the old ones, a lot of times whenever I would roll out to the left, I would say rolling out to the right side. I don't know why I did that, and I made like a note of it in the video, like I put right side of the question mark. I honestly have no idea why I was doing that, but, oh, what? Okay. I thought I could hit that slant right over the middle. I guess not, that linebacker's pretty athletic. So let's just go ahead and skip to when we're on the field now. And can our defense hold? Yes, they can. Okay, it's still 0-0. And if I don't do something big, we're going to lose coach trust. I mean, we're already in the negative now for this one. Wait, what's my new thing? Oh, I can call hot routes now, at home at least. I can't do it on the road yet, I don't believe, but I can do it at home now. And right there, Jarvis Baxter, 15-yard gain. I'm probably only going to call hot routes whenever I see, like, a potential deep ball. Like, whenever they come out in line... Shepard up on the outside and one-on-one, and I see the safety is like coming up, like ready to blitz. That is when I will audible to a deep route or something, because I know Shepard's probably going to beat his guy off the line. But on first down, whoa, wide open. Over the middle, Deron Neal. And that's going to be a 22-yard gain on the play. So we're driving now. So let's see if we can actually get into the end zone on this drive and not throw a pick. Also, if I'm like bouncing all over the place on commentary, that's probably going to take some getting used to for me. But like I said, if I'm bouncing all over the place, sorry. Trying to get back into the like commentary mode because I haven't commentated stuff in a few weeks. But Joe Mixon does have the first down on the play, a 13-yard gain. And that was probably a stupid play by me rolling out to the left. But it seemed to work out fine. 5 of 6, 89 yards, and a pick. Okay, so I said a few videos ago that I really like this route in the Oklahoma Dynasty. I think it's resulted in an incomplete pass and an interception. So, yeah, he's not open on that one. Oh, God, I'm trying to find someone open. There we go. And that's D.E. Westbrook got the first down down inside the 5-yard line. A 20-yard gain on the play. I'm having to roll out a lot in this game. If I don't see you in open, that's just like my initial instinct is to roll out and try to buy some time for people to get open. But first and goal, Samaje Perine in the backfield and pistol. And handoff to Perine. Yeah, he's in, right? And nope, down at the 1-yard line. 4-yard gain. Second and goal. What are we going to do, Bob? And it's this speed option play. I still have 5 extra plays, but I'm not going to use those yet. So second and goal, Samaje Perine with me in shotgun. And they come after me, so pitch it to Perine. And he is stopped for about a 2-yard loss. Okay, third and goal. Not a good play. I don't like that play. I've said that before. Just looking at the extra plays, but this looks like to be the best one. So on third and goal out of shotgun, we're going to give it to Perine and see if he can get into the end zone. Hand off to Samaje up the middle and into the end zone. Touchdown Sooners, a 3-yard touchdown run, and we go up 7-0 over Iowa State. I mean, as long as our kicker can make this. And it's good, okay. So that comes out first and 10, 1:05 to go in the first quarter, 80 yards away from the end zone. Our defense did hold, so we're still up 7-0. And we're apparently just going to run go routes here. And I believe that's Deron Neal open over the middle of the field. And that's going to be an easy completion. It was a deep ball, but there was nobody near him. That safety is apparently not that fast. I'm going to have to remember that. That's their strong safety. Their strong safety is not fast. Okay. First and 10, Sterling and shotgun. Perine in the backfield. That's, thought that was where we were going to go with it, but he's actually covered pretty well. So Riker gets the first down. I tried to slide. I hit square, but a lot of times I do it too late, and then he just ends up trying to, like, break tackles. I don't really want a halfback draw here, so we are going to use one of the extra plays. First and 10, Westbrook's outside, Baxter in the slot, Shepard. I don't really like that route for Shepard. Let's go and hot route that. Let's hot route that to a slant as well. So, and Baxter over the middle, wide open, first down and into the end zone. Touchdown Sooners, go up 14-0 over Iowa State. 8 of 9, 175 yards, and our only incomplete pass is that interception. Pretty good day so far, though I am making kind of a lot of easy passes. And our defense held again, so we're still shutting them out 14-0. Now in the second quarter, and I don't really see any good hot routes on this play, so we'll just go ahead and snap it and see what we can get. And go across the field, caught by Sterling Shepard, down near the 50-yard line, a 13-yard gain. So what are we now, like 9 of 10? Yep, 9 of 10, 188 yards, a touchdown, and a pick. So since I'm doing this commentary style, you guys will obviously get to see stats throughout the game and not just like near the end of it. But first and 10 inch shotgun, here we go. And wow, wide open. Okay, I'll just take that easy pass. I think I probably could have waited and someone else would have got open, but why risk it? Second and 4, come out in shotgun. Is that going to be, Mixon and Perine both in the backfield? I've not run the ball a whole lot today, but kind of getting used to that in this series. Second and 4, and wow. That play was blown up very fast. Loss of 4 on the play. I guess that was my right tackle's fault. Maybe they overloaded that side of the line or something. But 3rd and 8, Mark Andrews in the tight end slot. Shepard on the outside, Neal in the slot. And Westbrook on the outside. So where are we going to go? Yeah, going to Westbrook. Open first down, and that's going to be an 11-yard gain. We got hit on the play, too. But 11-yard gain, so keep this drive alive. Come out now, first and 10, 4 minutes to go in the second quarter. And on the outside this time is Neal, Jeffrey Meade in the slot, and I think we're going to audible that to a go route and see what that safety decides to do. And come on, break away from your route. There we go, circle. And Neal can't catch it, okay. I don't think I let him far enough downfield. I wanted to throw that farther downfield, but I guess because I was rolling out, throw power wasn't exactly 100% there. Westbrook is on. Can you, like, scoot in a little bit? I don't know if I can throw that pass. If I try to throw that, that might result in a pick. Unless I roll out and then heave it to Westbrook. And that is going to be Did he catch that? No, incomplete. Okay. I thought he had a chance to get that. And now we're running four verticals on 3rd and 10. Okay. Shepherd on this side and Baxter. That's probably where we're going to go is Baxter. Yep, right over the middle. Jarvis Baxter inside the 20. Stiff arming down to the 5 and a 34-yard gain on the play. So now we're 12 of 15 for 239 yards, a touchdown, and a pick. Next season, we might bump it up to Heisman difficulty because it feels like a lot of the time this season on All-American, it's been a little bit too easy. So next season, we'll think about bumping it up to Heisman. But first and goal, here we go, rolling out to the right side. And yeah, we're just going to dump that off to Samaje. Into the end zone, touchdown Oklahoma, 21-0 over Iowa State now. 13 of 16, 243 yards, two touchdowns and a pick. And Samaje also has a rushing touchdown, I believe. And our defense cannot hold them that time, 21-7. So the shutout dream is now dead. I was actually looking at Iowa State's schedule, and they were actually shut out by, I think, Baylor, like 28-0. So just kind of a weird random fact. Going downfield now, and that was a risky pass. Okay. So probably not my best decision there. But now Sterling's going to come out and shotgun. Neal in the slot. Shepherd on the outside. Westbrook's coming across the middle. They're scooting that safety up, and I think Westbrook can handle that guy in one-on-one. They are going to blitz the safety, and Westbrook cannot handle that guy one-on-one. But wide open, Deron Neal with Mark Andrews out there to block, and a first down for the Sooners, a 16-yard gain on the play. Three catches, 89 yards. 14 of 18, 259, two TDs and a pick. I'm going to end up saying stats a lot. But what in the world are they doing? Okay, that was a weird audible, and now Shepard's left wide open, but their safety's coming over to help. And what the... Okay. I read that route wrong. Let me go to the replay and show you guys what I thought was going to happen. So, they called an audible or something, and Shepard beat his guy. I don't know what that guy was even supposed to do, like come in and play zone. But I saw that safety, so I didn't want to risk that. So I was looking at Jarvis Baxter here, and I thought he was going to keep running downfield. Like, I thought he was going to come, like, all the way in this area. So right here is whenever I hit the button, and then he stopped, and it almost resulted in an interception. But I thought he was going to keep running downfield. So that's why I hit that button. Just kind of clarifying why that looked like a really, really stupid pass. Okay, 2nd and 10. Baxter in the slot, and it's kind of an overpowered play, but we're going to run anyway. First down, and can we keep going? Down to the 40-yard line, a 19-yard gain on the play. And we're doing pretty good on the ground this season. I mean, I've said this before, I've done a few Road to Glories, like, off recording, and, like, always, like, throughout the Road to Glory, I end up being the team's running game because they never run the ball. But D.D. Westbrook inside the 5, touchdown Sooners, a 40-yard touchdown pass. That's number 3 on the day. 15 of 20, nearing 300 yards. We're 1 yard away from it. Well, let's see if our defense can hold them right before halftime. And, okay, they actually get us the ball back before halftime. With a decent field position enough to score. So on 1st and 10, 20 seconds to go in the half. And take the snap. And, yeah, we're going to throw that to the outside. Caught by Westbrook. Now into field goal range and down. 31-yard gain. And we burn a timeout. 16 seconds to go in the half. And do we want to go to the end zone here? Yeah, I think we are. I think we're definitely going to the end zone on this play. If no one's open, I'm going to run because we still have a timeout, so I'm not really worried about running down the clock. Yeah, get away from me. Oh, my God. I have to burn the last timeout. I can't believe that. And I forgot that I can't audible. So it looks like we're running a screen. This is just a bad ending to the half. You know what? No. We're not going to run a screen. We're going to air it out. Never mind. I wanted to air it out to Shepherd. I thought I would get enough time. Yeah, let's run that. And then I can audible this to a Hail Mary pretty much. And yeah, that'll work. Okay, there's the snap. And I believe that's Westbrook breaking away or maybe Shepherd. And that's picked off. Okay, so I threw our second pick of the day on a pretty much Hail Mary throw. Probably should have thrown that a lot sooner, but, you know, whatever. And our defense does hold them to start the half, so we get the ball back here. So come out up 28-7 still. Deron Neal in the slot. Baxter's kind of fast. We're going to send Baxter on a go route here. If Baxter manages to get open, then he gets open. If he doesn't, oh well. And loss of 13. Just a stupid play by me. I mean, it would also help if my lineman would remember how to block on that play, but still. Let's see what we can do. Second and 23. And, alright, they're blocking pretty good here, and I've got to roll out. I got to buy time. And go down the field. Caught by Westbrook, and never mind. Dropped it. Not caught by Westbrook. Building it onto it. Okay, third and 23. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Shepard and Neal on the outside. Can I flip this play? Nope, not now. I have to do it, like, in play calling. And lob that across. Oh. I don't know what the heck I'm doing right now. I've done a lot of stupid plays in a row now. And Iowa State scored. Okay. First and 10. Coming out in shotgun. Baxter in the slot. Neal in the slot. Shepard on the outside. And Westbrook on the outside. See where we can go with this. Let's take some easy throws. Let's not risk anything right now. Let's just take some easy throws. Move down the field. And just go ahead and slow down for a minute. I do not want to lose to Iowa State. Especially not whenever we were up 28-7. And I was kind of hoping he would get open there, but, you know, we're just going to take off. Screw it. And step out of bounds. A 9-yard gain sets up second and one. Can we just run it with Samaje here, please? I need to take some, like, pressure off of Riker Sterling or something. And no one's covering Jarvis Baxter. So that's where I'm going with it. Easy first down. There was nobody on him. So that's a 9-yard gain. And I would have audible to a go route, but that safety obviously would have picked him up or something. I imagine. But right there, yeah, I'll take that easy pass. That's no problem. Now we're going to hand off to Samaje. Or no, now it's Joe Mixon in the backfield. I don't really care. We just need to run the ball a little bit. So we can open up the pass game a little bit more. Hand off to Mixon up the middle. Good blocking. And Joe Mixon has a first down on the play. 11 yards per carry. Oh, he's only got one carry. Never mind. That was... Okay, just disregard that I said that, please. First and 10. Kind of want to send someone deep, but I don't really see any good spots to, so we'll just take the slant routes. Oh crap, I just saw Circle was wide open on the play. Crap. I didn't even look at Circle. I looked at Square, Triangle, and X. I didn't even look over at Circle, and he was wide open running across the middle. So sorry about that, Baxter, because I think that was Jarvis Baxter there. So second and 8, and now is Circle going to be open over the middle? Yes, he is. Slant route, first down, D.D. Westbrook. And that's forward progress, 10-yard gain. Okay. So we're still moving down the field pretty good. I don't want to make this... I don't want to give them a chance to make it a one-possession game. That's what I'm trying to say. I do not want to give them a chance to make it a one-possession game. So now we're going to roll it to the right side. Come on, break away from your route, Circle. Never mind, you waited too long. And we'll take the first down, get shoved out of bounds. 12-yard gain for Riker Sterling. I'm afraid I'm going to get hit and get injured at some point. So now, what do we do? Okay. So I remember this play because we ran it with P-Ryan one time, and he was wide open the entire route for a touchdown. And is Mixon going to do the same thing? Doesn't matter, I'm lobbing it to the back of the end zone anyway. And almost intercepted. Probably not a good idea. 19-29, 361 yards. Three touchdowns and two picks, right? Yeah, because we threw the one early in the game on the first drive, and then we threw the one at the end of the first half. Second and 10, and comeback route to overpowered. Sterling Shepard, touchdown Sooners. That's our fourth touchdown pass of the day. And now we're up 35-14. So maybe our defense can hold them here? All right, 35-17. So that's obviously better than nothing. Let's go ahead and run the ball. Maybe if we score on this drive, I think Coach might pull us, maybe, might sit us for the rest of the game, I don't know, but Piran up the middle, and that's a 5-yard gain on the play. I think Piran's only got like two carries so far, and yeah, I used an extra play because I want to, oh, Piran has five carries, what? Okay, well, I used an extra play because I wanted to see if we get anything passing, and right there over the middle, Sterling Shepard got the first down near the 50, an 18-yard gain on the play. We have 400 yards yet? Have we gotten there yet? What's our career high, by the way? I think it's like 500, right? Okay, we're at 392. But our career high is like 500. I think that was against Tulsa. But first and 10. And take the snap. Please, someone get open. And I don't see anyone open. Just going to take off and get out of bounds. 5-yard gain. Probably could have made a risky pass there, but really didn't want to. So now second and 5. Under 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. We're sending Westbrook deep again. Maybe he can beat his guy this time. Doesn't look like it, so we'll find Jarvis Baxter. He still doesn't wait at the end of his route, and I complained about that one game where he didn't, like, he gets to the end of his route and then immediately breaks away from it. Look, it's this exact same play, and I'm going to call some hot routes. But, like, he hits his out route and then is, like, gone. He doesn't sit there and wait for the ball or anything. All right, last play of the third quarter. Over the middle, finds Mark Andrews down inside the five-yard line. 34-yard gain. No one was covering the tight end on that play. I don't know why. But, you know, I'm not going to complain too much. So that will take us to the fourth quarter, and we're up 35-17. I couldn't read for a second. So first and goal from the two-yard line, and we're coming out in shotgun. This makes sense. The Chip Kelly-style offense. First and goal. Here we go. And rolling out to the right side, trying to find someone open. And, yeah, we're just going to take off. Touchdown, Riker Sterling, our fifth total touchdown of the day. Puts us up 42-17. Are we going to get to come back in this game, though, is the question. And it looks like we are. Okay. So Bob is not done running up the score on these guys. And we're in the middle of the field, so I really don't want to send anyone on a go route here. First and 10. And, all right, circle got open on a slant route. There we go. First down, D.D. Westbrook. And a 16-yard gain. How close are we to 500 yards now? Westbrook has 7 catches for 140 yards. We're at 453. We could potentially get our career high here if our career high is still 500. I'm not going to guarantee that it is still 500. But on first and 10, going to send Westbrook deep and see what he can do. And, wow, he is wide open. D.D. Westbrook to the end zone. Touchdown Sooners. A 40-yard touchdown pass where there was no one within 15 yards of him. And I think now we're going to be pulled because we're up by 32 points as long as we make this. And, yeah, we're up by 32. And, yeah, it looks like we are done for the day. And we score again. So final score, 56-17. We pretty much dominated the entire game. For some reason, the play of the game is the touchdown pass that pulled us from the game. I don't know why, because the game was plenty out of reach at that point. But I will go ahead and take it. So 6 total touchdowns today, 5 passing, 1 running, I believe, and 25 of 35, 493 yards, 10 carries for 38 yards. So we didn't have a tremendous day on the ground, but we did have a great day through the air, minus that couple interceptions. Okay, so now we're going to look at some stats. Riker Sterling, 25 of 35, 493 yards, 5 touchdowns, 2 interceptions, 71% completion percentage, and we were sacked 3 times. When was our longest pass of 51? I honestly have no idea. But rushing yards, 10 carries, 38 yards, and a touchdown. Joe Mixon, 9 carries, 50 yards, and a touchdown. Samaje Perine, 5 carries, 17 yards, and a touchdown. Receiving-wise, D.D. Westbrook, 8 catches, 180 yards, and 2 touchdowns. He had a monster day. Jarvis Baxter, 5 for 84 and a score. Shepard, 4 for 69 and a touchdown. And Perine caught 1 pass for 4 yards and a touchdown. So now let's go ahead and advance to the next week to see who we will be playing. Or I know who we're playing. I think it's Kansas State, and they are ranked. So let's go ahead and jump to that and see if we move up in the rankings at all. Okay, so we actually move up to number 2 in the country. Who lost? That's what I want to know, is who in the world lost? Because there's no way we jumped anyone after beating Iowa State. Auburn lost. They lost to Georgia 12-27. And who was the people that just jumped us? Stanford lost to USC. Okay. So now it's between us and Notre Dame. And if that's the national championship, that would actually be pretty funny. Because I think that was the national championship game in season 4 of the Oklahoma Dynasty. But let's check Heisman Watch and then we'll go look at BCS rankings. I know I said we're not going to really look at top 25 rankings the rest of the year. I think I said that a couple videos ago, but yeah, I lied. So Riker Sterling is still up top of the Heisman watch list. Raymond Wright is second. Keenan Reynolds, Royce Freeman, and Peyton Barber. Oh, Barber didn't do anything against Georgia. Look at that. 18 carries for 54 yards. That's not good. Okay, so let's go ahead and check the BCS rankings now. And are we 1, 2, or 3? We are 3. USC jumped from 8 to 2. Are you joking? They jumped from 8. They're a 2-loss team. No. No, they are I know we beat Iowa State, and they beat, you know, the number, like, two or three team in the country. But they're a two-loss team. They lost to Arizona and Notre Dame. So they lost back-to-back games. Both, you know, against top five teams. But that's insane that they are a two-loss team over a one-loss. And our only loss was to Notre Dame, right? Correct? I believe, yeah, our only loss was to Notre Dame. And then who in the world did Notre Dame lose to? Notre Dame lost to Michigan. Okay. So, these, like, top five teams, that's just going to be chaotic. UCLA is 7-3 and number 6. See, you guys, this is why we got rid of the BCS system. Because this is ridiculous. An 8-2 team over 3-9-1 teams. Notre Dame does deserve to be number 1, I will say that, because they've beaten USC, Oklahoma. Who else have they played? They beat Michigan State, who is ranked. They beat Navy, who's ranked. And they still have Stanford to play. So, Notre Dame definitely deserves to be number 1, but I don't think USC deserves to be 2. Who is Oregon, or who is Arizona beat? Who do they lost to UCLA. So right now, the Pac-12 is just, like, chaotic right now. And that's why we're not going to be settled until the conference championship. That's insane. We'll look at awards winners at the end of the season. Let's check skill upgrade and see if there's anything that we can get this week. Just like this. What is that? We do need some carrying. We might use that. What's fan boost? That's just a one game thing. Read and react. Let it go. Okay. So yeah, we're just going to go ahead and get that and go ahead and up our carrying so we don't fumble as often, because I don't think we fumbled too much, but I'm afraid that it's gonna come back to bite us. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Next game is at number 23 K-State. Who in the world did you guys lose to? We are predicted to win. It's in Manhattan. So let's see. Who did you guys lose to? They lost to TCU 10-31. So we have two games left in the regular season, and then we get to decide get to see who our bowl game is. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this, and I will talk to you guys next time.